Hello and welcome to the first ever broadcast of the Mighty Elstow, which is the official, can we call it the official?
Official, unofficial, unofficial, the, official,
the,
unofficial.
The okay. Official, unofficial podcast of Elstow Cricket Club, featuring Kiwi Jeff, woohoo! Jono Phil.
Good evening.
And me, Henry. I'm the secretary of the club. Phil, you are the head coach. Same. And Jeff, you are a visionary. You are the reason we're here, sir. So good on you. So that's who we are. Tell the listeners about Elstow Cricket Club, Jeff.
Well, what a fine cricket club it is. We've got youth. We've got adults.
Whereabouts is Elstow? I mean, say for example, you've logged on to the podcast dome or whatever it is. I don't know. I presume it's like a shop. You just go in there and you pick. I want that.
I think so.
Presumably you're brand new to this. Where is Elstow?
We are the heart of mighty Bedfordshire.
Leafy Bedfordshire.
If I'm ignorant and I don't know where Bedfordshire is, because, you know, I
an hour north of London.
Right, okay.
And it's like Tamworth. It's so far away from the sea that, yeah.
Yeah, we are a long way from the sea here, aren't we? We are.
Yeah, now we're north of London in leafy Bedfordshire, rural Bedfordshire in the United Kingdom.
Indeed. Well, so I think that's the geography covered. And apologies if we don't know the exact sort of location on the Vedic or industry or whatever. But anyway, so that's where we are. So we are a village cricket club formed in 1947. And I think it's only fair to say we're amongst friends here. We're a bit rubbish. We have our moments.
Proper village.
The t-shirt says it all. We are proper village. We care. I mean, hey, look, we are just a load of old boys out to enjoy our cricket and make some friends, have some beers
and have fun
because ultimately.
That's what it's all about, H. That's what it's all about, mate.
And when cricket stops doing that, they can turn off the lights and we'll all leave. but for now, we're Elstow and we're plodding on with youth development, aren't we, Jeff?
We are indeed. It's interesting Phil can say it's fun, because when he crosses that white line, I'm not sure that's how it comes
about. What a fever, isn't it?
Blue touch paper.
Not as bad as Stevie Russ.
I hardly play, but Jeff, you're on the field. You're quite a placid individual. You're as befitting, much of your wonderful countrymen from New Zealand. You're quite a laid back, phlegmatic individual. You play with Phil, Phil Johnson, and the aforementioned Steve Russell. They're both not so laid back on the field. They both take their cricket seriously. I mean, we all take it seriously, right? But these really take it seriously. Could you try and explain to the listeners who the angriest is? Who's why they? Oh. What makes them angry? No, Phil. This is for Jeff. I mean, you can come in on this, but
it's easy to say that Phil's the angriest cricketer I've ever played with.
He's the angriest you ever played with.
This is ridiculous.
He's Mr. Angry.
Yeah, I mean, you played in London, for goodness sake. I mean,
played in the Tron.
I've played in the Tron, but that was
the Tron. Where's the Tron?
The heart of the mighty Waikato. Hamilton, New Zealand.
Goodness me.
Quality.
Absolutely. It's currently internationally, who's from Hamilton that plays cricket currently?
Wow. The list, it's a long list.
It's a long list, but you can't think of anyone at the moment. Fantastic.
Scott Styris, Daniel Vettori.
Is Dan Vettori from Hamilton?
Oh, is he? Born and bred.
How big's his beard nowadays?
God love him.
I haven't seen him in a little while. How big's his beard?
Well, it looks big. The problem with Denny is he's had some injury issues, so we haven't seen as much of him as we'd like
for a little while.
And I'm glad to say that the Northern Knights aren't missing him. They've just smashed the Cape Cobras this evening without him.
You say Cobra, I say Cobra. I mean, that's way down the AOB.
It's a bit. It's
proper pronunciation. I mean, that in turn, opens up a whole new hornet's nest of
key. Shall we say,
why is Phil the angriest man you've ever played cricket with?
Back to this. We're 4 minutes.
I don't know why, and no one will ever explain it. All I can say is Thurlow away last year, Matt Sampson. Yeah. Myself, he wasn't very happy. He was not very happy.
He was sat in your pants with a bacon sandwich when we were meant to be there, Jeff, and I came to pick you up, and you were fairly worse aware with your glasses all askew. That's all I'm going to say.
This is like Browning. What's that time?
It was not Browning. Yeah. Naked at the front door.
This is a bit like the pot and kettle there, old chap. I mean, but anyway, so Steve Russell, he's also angry, Jeff, right?
He is.
Why is he angry?
Because
everyone wants him to bowl full, and all he bowls is short.
Right. So that's, you commend that.
We've sort of got a tangent here, but let us just say that Steve Russell,
who does a wonderful job as our development 11.
I hope he's listening. I'm going to throw in the towel. I hope he was ripping it up and throwing it back in my face. I hope he is chuckling away. But Steve Russell, if they had a pitch map on Sky, they would need to extend it back to his feet by a fair distance. He got a hat-trick this year, Steve Russell. It was one of the highlights of the year. He got a hat-trick. He took 6 foot. All from balls that pitched about an inch away from his foot, his front foot. Fantastic. He got 6 foot, and it was the strangest 6 foot I've ever seen. We didn't give him man of the match.
No, he was the angriest man in the world
afterwards. It was quite funny, but he took it all in good stead.
Hey, all I can say is Evershot away, last match of the season, end of season friendly. There was a partnership rivaling the classic Mintmore.
Good Lord, of
Elstow history, where, you know, it wasn't a last wicket partnership. We had Henry Whiston and Steve Day to come in.
Yes.
But Steve and I put on over 100 runs to win us the game from a nigh-on unwinnable position.
I was going to say cricket was the winner there, but it wasn't. It was the Lasagna afterwards was the winner. It was terrific. Really was.
Russ, raising a glass to you. What an innings. What a player. Fantastic, mate.
If anyone from Evershot's listening, thank you very much for your hospitality, gents. You were fabulous.
Especially their bowlers, because there must have been about 30 extras in the last 100 runs we scored, which was lovely.
So, talking on that, so we've established where we are, who we are, where we come from. This sounds like a well-known English cricket ditty at this stage. So let's get away from that. And if the Barmy Army are listening, it'd be lovely to hear from you.
Yes, absolutely.
We've got one of them. Big G is one of our vice presidents.
Yes.
One of these sort of man. Vice presidents that we've named, but we don't see a lot of. So hopefully.
Heather sent Taz Valley last year.
He's a great guy. We love Big G. He's a great singer, but we just like more pics of you with the England ladies and Yorkshire tea in sort of promoting Elstow Cricket Club.
That would be lovely. That would be great.
That's what you think. That's what you're there for, mate. But keep up the good work, old boy. So anyway, who's going to listen? So the Barmy Army are going to be listening, obviously. The Beige Brigade are going to be listening. Why are the Beige Brigade going to be listening?
So this is one of the reasons why we're here. Firstly, it's a bit of a response to the Beige Brigade podcast, the BYC, which is, by the way, fantastic. Jeff, you can vouch for that, can't you?
It's brilliant. I've been trying to make it go viral in Bedfordshire.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Slowly working. It's got
there are things going viral in Bedfordshire, but you only tend to see those at closing time.
Ron Lilly can attest to that.
Yes, he can.
But hey, it's the first show. I mean, we don't want to start dragging up that sort of muck. I mean, goodness.
Shindy, indeed. So the Beige Brigade. Their podcast is absolutely fantastic.
Second best podcast in the pod.
You were saying it's the only one I think I know. So, but you think
second best behind Danny Baker?
Danny Baker's pretty good. It is excellent though. But obviously Jeff's obviously from the motherland of. The Beige Brigade, but myself and Henry, I owe a massive debt of gratitude to the boys there, to Mike, to Blair, the Goosh. Who can forget the Goosh? Fastest tit cricket century.
Hit tit or
tit cricket tit
tit
tit tit. Right.
Okay. We're going to.
Another time.
So he could probably have his own podcast.
He definitely could. This is the professional possum hunter, champion rabbit shooter.
If they could get the technology down to Winton.
I don't think that's possible for the next 20 years.
So Winton, I need to, in this instance, refers to where he comes from as opposed to the orange-faced DJ who used to present Supermarket Sweep.
Not Dale.
He doesn't come. No, that would be an interesting podcast. That's something we could have the Winton podcast. Hey, I don't know where I come up with this.
The Goosh and Dale Winton.
And Dale Winton.
In a supermarket. In a supermarket trolley.
Yes.
It has to be a big trolley.
Yeah, it has to be a very big trolley. But he could have his own podcast, couldn't he, the Goosh?
Yes. No, he could. He could. Winton, yeah. So Winton's a small village right down the south of... In fact, it's probably the furthest place away from Elstow in the world.
So that's on the South Island?
Yeah, New Zealand.
Near
Invercargill.
Right.
Near Bluff.
What do you do down in Winton?
Shoot possum.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else?
There's some top quality stuff going on there.
It's actually a lovely
Bluff
place.
Bluff oysters. Oh, lovely, what a place. Lovely spot.
Deer shooting. They've got a doubtful sound nearby. It's unbelievable place.
Good.
So the Goosh, cracking fella. Obviously, Mike Blair, Al Willis. Who else have we got? Kev Sinnott. What a chap.
Oh.
And Vice President, the Godfather himself.
President of what?
Elstow Cricket Club.
He's not.
He
Paul
is.
Paul Ford is. Yeah.
Bloody hell.
Yeah.
Good stuff, pal.
Good on you, Paul.
Good stuff, pal.
No,
so, but we owe them obviously a massive debt of gratitude. We've had some very many drunken nights with them in Kiwi Land and sober occasions as well.
It does sound almost like the Vice President's list, a little bit like the New Year's Honours list. A lot of people are on there. They don't realise why they're there, but they are. But no, with you, Fordo, you are an incredible person. Thank you very much indeed for your hospitality. Looking after me and Phil when we've been out there. Thank you for your work in Anglo-New Zealand cricket relations.
Getting the BYC on.
Getting the BYC. On cricket info. Yeah, absolutely. and good luck with all the writing. It's fantastic. Yeah. So, top man. Good on you, mate. But we're not here to blow smoke up your arsehole, chap. We're here to talk about Elstow Cricket Club. Chaps, this season then?
Yeah, cracking season. I won't go into too much detail, a match by match analysis, but certainly from the first 11 point of view, we went down to the wire, and unfortunately just came up short. But it was a cracking season.
Went on holiday, wasn't it?
Wasn't ideal, boys. Second, two games from home, 12 points up, and six you decide to go on holiday.
Never have holidays in the cricket season.
Never.
Well, I don't know how that never. I mean, it should be in the constitution, shouldn't
constitution.
It?
Constitution.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless they're stag weekends.
Yeah, no, that
when
was...
When everyone goes.
Yeah, that's true. We had a cracking effort, just finished short, but it was a very, very exciting finish. Unfortunately, Olney went down. We'd like Bindham to go down, but I think
we don't want to say anyone.
It was a really good season. We had a couple of two hat tricks in one season.
That's
thank God that somebody's not Tony Harper.
If Ali Milne's listening, he could probably correct us there.
Oh, probably, because he's probably had a few.
But again, there's more chance of podcasts getting to Winton before Wales.
That is true.
Which is where Ali currently is.
But two hat tricks in the same season. But what that was really strange, it was that they were from two of the unlikely sources. We'll go back to Steve Russ again.
Oh, we're not getting
on No.
You're on your Steve.
No, he got 6 feet. It was a good hat-trick. But Matt Stevens, who had barely bowled an over, ended up getting a hat-trick.
Very underrated bowler.
Very misunderstood.
Very underrated bowler.
Good old viral. It was a cracking season. Some very funny moments. A lot of them from Dick of the Season, Rani Tiara. Jeff, what about I wasn't there, but what about the Willie Peck moment? There were certainly some memorable moments, but there were some funny moments too. What about Willie Peck,
the legend? Well, hang on, who is Willie Peck?
Vice President, generally great man.
He is a great man.
Well, the man that inspired the name of the bar, the Pigeon Toe Inn at Elstow Cricket Club.
Pigeon Toe Inn.
basically Elstow legend, played in my first match when I came to Elstow in 2005.
Yeah.
Always a man that you'd want to have a beer with.
Definitely. Maybe.
You just want to make sure you're not with him at the end of the night because that means you're in trouble.
Yeah.
But absolute gentleman. Mm. Lovely chap. Likes his diesel.
Which we need to clarify here. That's a
snake white and black,
right? As opposed to the stuff you put in your car.
Indeed.
Crude oil. Although I wouldn't rule that out, frankly. We like Willie so much, and again we're drifting from the point. As a tangent, we're leaving town on it.
Jeff, what happened?
Well, Willie offered to umpire because we were short of an umpire for the match, and he he stepped in, which we're very grateful for, and he did a sterling job. Mm. It's unusual to have an umpire appealing with the bowling side,
yes,
however.
It's unconventional.
It is unconventional.
It's unconventional.
If he's out, he's out, surely.
Well, Willie certainly thought so.
Yes.
And then, you know, half a second later realised he was the arbiter of the decision.
Yes.
and had to raise his finger. Which was somewhat amusing.
Presumably the batsman was doing that at him at that stage.
I don't think the batsman was in any doubt that he was on his way.
That sounds... village. Proper village. Absolutely. That's what we are. Proper village is what we are. So that was a memorable moment from the season just gone there, boys.
Absolutely. Yeah. And even in a league where anything down league is a wide... Mm. Willie will always give you one.
I've heard that.
Good on him.
I've heard that. Again, it was so many in your nose, not enough time.
It was a very good season. Grego, we had a...
Who's Grego?
Grego, Aussie.
Another one. We seem to bring
them. We've got a couple there now. But they're good chaps. We've had a few good Antipodeans over.
They're great people. They are. I just wouldn't tell them.
No, we don't tell them.
Is this live?
No, sure. It's fine. I'll edit that bit out.
Good.
So Grego made his maiden 100 for the club, and he was leading run scorer with 500 runs. But his maiden 100 did feature, when he was on 95, he edged to maybe wide gully, maybe backward point. It was quite evident. Didn't walk. The umpire was sort of not really looking, so... didn't give him out.
He was their umpire as well, wasn't he?
Oh yeah, it was the most bizarre moment of the game. He started to walk and then realised that he wasn't out. So
proper village.
Yeah, it was proper village.
Proper village.
I was standing at the other end. I was trying not to
laugh.
I was stifling my laughter.
He was. He went out to make his 100 anyway. It's fully deserved. He deserved one, to be fair, this season. So done well.
Because I've been working most Saturdays and I'm giving essentially, I'm not really good, but no, it was the first time I got to see Greg bat on Sunday. He's brilliant.
Yeah.
He's not live though, so it's fine. He'll never find out. But he's played all the shots, hasn't he? He's got more, hasn't he?
Yeah, actually, he's a bloody player.
Yeah. Good wicketkeeper as well.
He's mental. That's the problem. I was going to say he's a good wicketkeeper, but part of the reason that he's a good batsman as well is because he's mental. We saw that in the pub the first night he came.
Right.
He's mental. I mean, he's brilliant mental, but you know. When I first played with him in Australia, the first game I played with, you know, and I'm not quick by any means, but he was standing up without any pads or a box.
Whereabouts in Australia was this?
Nambour Cricket Club.
Nambour
the
Cricket
Mighty
Club.
Cutters.
Mighty Cutters.
Hopefully Matt Sampson's listening. Sambo.
Good old Sambo.
So hopefully we'll continue our links with the boys there. But yeah, that's at Nambour on Sunshine Coast in just north of Brisbane.
They're great people. They came all the way from Australia to play against us because that was actually my little quiz for you guys. Name the three international cricket grounds I've been or am going to this week.
Ooh.
But while you're pondering that, three international cricket grounds I've been to this week or I'm going to. They came all the way from Nambour to play us in the
3M's Trophy.
The 3M's Trophy last summer, which coincided with the Ashes, and it coincided with the visit of your mob, the Mighty Kiwis, to these shores as well.
Indeed, it did.
We had a charity event. It was a 2020 competition.
Tri-Nations.
The Tri-Nations, named after three unheralded... Can we say batsman? Three M's. So there was Martin, Chris Martin,
Tom Martin,
What a player!
What a player! That's the bowl engine bowler, not the cold play cobbler. Or indeed, it needs qualifying the ex Luton Town striker, who I believe is now playing at Derby.
Is that right?
I think so.
He's gone down in the world then.
Well, I think you leave Luton. That's generally the consensus. But Mullally.
Alan Mullally.
Our boy. And of course, Pidge McGrath as well.
Yeah.
They were the three, weren't they? So it's a 3M's trophy. It was brilliant. That was last summer. But Nambour, they came all the way over. Not en masse, but
there's a few of them, and there's a few of the boys that were over here for whatever reason during the summer. Stutz and Johnny Francis and some of the boys there came and had a good old crack at Elstow for the weekend.
They did. Which actually, that's my second question of the and in fact, it's probably going to be Chris depends on whether we get commissioned for a second episode or not. But my second question is going to be, apart from the three international games I've been to this week, the second question, where's Willie?
Where's Wally
Knuckles has been playing for the London New Zealand Cricket Club. What? The London New Zealand Cricket Club.
Cricket Club.
Thank you. Make sure we got the bells in the right place there. The rain in Spain and all that, Jeff.
Apparently he's been causing havoc for him.
Why has it been causing havoc up the M1, mate?
We're keeping a bit of tabs. He's been playing for London New Zealand Cricket Boys. Haven't really had the chance to catch up with him this year.
Yeah.
But, interesting
fella. Interesting in the rose at 1 o'clock in the morning as well.
I'm sure. Most people are. This is very, very odd.
Good chat though. Give us a
So he's still around.
Oh, he's definitely still around, yeah.
But just not returning.
Well, he's down in London, isn't he? Enjoying all of the opportunities that London
involves. TV or radio or something, or Radio New Zealand or whatever, I don't know.
I pick up his tweets. We do love Willie, and we just want you to get in touch, mate. So Willie Nichols of New Zealand, if you are listening to this,
we'll have to text.
Please get in touch, mate. Come and have a beer.
Come and
have a beer, or you're doing really well with getting these words in that you were told to get them. Fantastic.
Well, keep Willie away from the microphone, mate, if we can.
Yeah.
Well, because we should probably think about wrapping up soon. Thank you all very much for your company, those of you that are still with us. we should.
Skeletons of the
space. Indeed. We should probably start planning for future shows. So I'd like to think Willie Nichols, if he gets in touch with us. If you are out there, please get in touch with us. You can have your own show. So he could do something.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yes, satellite link.
I've also got written down here Strudzy, Big Doug, Jimmy, one of our vice presidents, James Strudzy.
Star of when Elstow CC were on live television.
Yeah, 5 years ago now. Brilliant. With the lovely Sarah Jane Mee.
Maybe she could come on.
Maybe she's listening. I doubt it. So Strozzi could come on. He could do a turn on here. We could perhaps have Archive Hour with Ted Bowen, another one of our vice presidents.
Yes.
Ted, he knows his game. He knows the game. Knows the local game.
I don't think he'll be listening.
I don't think he'll be listening. No. But Ted, if you are listening,
Story time with Ted Bowen.
You've made it. You've absolutely made it. We could have some kind of cookery thing with Tesco Knowledge.
Yeah.
Another one of our. You were just listing a vice president.
You'd be the Ollie, what's his name, of the wine. You'd be coming with the what wine can go with this, wouldn't you?
I can't believe
the food I've cooked and the wine, you know, we've had.
By the way, hats off.
Lovely real cream.
And Tesco Knowledge is going to be cooking.
The Marquis de Risco, you've just provided the one. Yeah, Marquis de Risco, 2009, we're on the moment, it's fantastic. It is really
cherry
good
tomatoes in the burger, why would you do that?
It was very good. So Tesco Knowledge could do something. Kane could come on and do his impressions. He's very good, young Kane.
We could get Kane versus Danny Morrison, who is actually...
The loudest.
Who's actually Danny Morrison? Maybe they could, you know.
True.
Who's
the
real Danny Morrison?
I don't think the real Danny Morrison knows.
Please stop that.
As a Kiwi, we could really just not bother with our whole section.
All right.
Okay, that's fine. Good. All right. Well, that's one thing less to worry about. And finally, I think around Christmas time, Kenners, our mate Kenners could come on.
He'll do a couple of carols.
Yeah, carols with Kenners.
Carols with Kenners.
Or Kenners Carols. Or yeah. Something like that. Yeah, you know, there's as much alliteration there, Christmas-based alliteration, Kenners Christmas Carols, as much Christmas-based alliteration as you could shake a stick at. So there's something to be getting on with. So we've got that. So it's not a complete washout. We've come up with some ideas and stuff. You've got all your words in that that the players asked you to get in.
Tripod.
Another one, fantastic. We've reviewed the season, which we're going to go probably. We've got to review other things as well. We're going to talk about our fantastic juniors again, Jeff, and how well they did again.
Well, absolutely. We should try and get a youngster on.
Yeah.
Give us the lowdown on the under tens.
Yeah, we are broadcasting past most of their bedtime.
We'll have to do a matinee, I think.
Yeah, a matinee. We should. Yeah, we should do one. So the grandma's
we can at least get some reports in from the team managers.
Yeah, I've tried that in previous seasons and
team managers. Yeah. Because we do have some fantastic young players coming through.
No, we do. That's one of the positive things that are burgeoning young players.
They're good guys. Jack Flynn, what a player. What a player.
Indeed. And if anyone wants to manage an indoor third team, then...
Wherever you're listening in the world.
I was going to say,
the more remote, the better. In fact, if you can do it, if we can find a way of linking you up to the Warren to coach, so you're coaching via the medium of podcast or Twitter sphere or something, brilliant. So all the more bizarre.
I'm not sure this is the kind of platform for it, but fair enough. If Henry was very passionate there, you can't see him, but he was waving his hands furiously at the computer,
gesticulating like John McCrory. He's
interesting man.
He's an interesting man. Erstwhile bookmaker.
Henry head in hands.
You don't
need to know.
So I think that's about covered it. Just the answer to
your question.
My question.
Henry,
yeah.
Lords. You're going to Lords tomorrow for Cousin Daniel's birthday.
Yes.
You've been to Chester Street.
Yes. The third international cricket venue.
Is it the Warren Elstow Cricket Club?
It is the Warren Elstow Cricket Club.
Get in.
There we go. So that is the three international venues I have been to this week. And it's time for me to thank Jeff Cooley. Thank Phil Johnson.
Thank you very much.
And thank you, dear listener, for listening in to the first and possibly last ever version of the Mighty Elstow, the official unofficial podcast of Elstow Cricket Club. If we don't see you in a week, we'll see you through a window.
And hang on, lads. If anyone wants to get in touch, you can email us at elstowcricketclub@hotmail.co.uk. And we're probably on Facebook and Twitter as well, but I'm a Neanderthal when it comes to these things, so the boys will sort that out.
I've just done the perfect sign up line there, and he's just come in there.
We'll have to try and edit it off.
We are.
Well, if you
we'll keep it on. No,
if
that's
you
fine.
No, the opportunity for people to contact us.
So let's pretend none of that ever happened.
Okay.
And ladies and gentlemen, if we don't see you in a week, we will see you through a window.